When integrating services with Oracle's Integration Cloud, first create connections for the integrations, and then integrate those connections. For a RightNow and Sales Cloud integration, let's start by creating a RightNow connection. Select the RightNow adapter from the list. Add basic information about the connection. Add the email address of the person who's going to act as contact administrator. Add the URL of the WSDL that allows Integration Cloud to find the RightNow instance. Because the application is password protected, add the credentials required to access it. Next, test the connection. When the test completes successfully, save and exit the canvas. The new RightNow connection appears in the connections list. Repeat the configuration process for the Oracle Sales Cloud connection by entering the basic information about the new connection, the contact email ID of the Sales Cloud admin, WSDL information, and credentials required to access the WSDL. Test the connection and save and close the canvas. The new Sales Cloud connection appears in the connections list. After the source and target connections are created, create an integration. First, enter basic information about the integration. Then, to configure the integration, configure the trigger and the invoke. Then map the business objects that flow between them. On the integration canvas, configure the RightNow connection as a trigger. Add basic information about the connection in the connection configuration wizard. Then configure how to process the request. To receive organization objects in the request, select organization from the list. Then, move on to the response. Because this is a one-way flow and there's no response, select none. Review the summary of selections. Now that it's configured, the canvas shows the RightNow instance and its inbound flow. Configure the invoke using the Oracle Sales Cloud connection, following the same steps as for the trigger. Fill in the basic information. To create an account in Oracle Sales Cloud, select the Account Service from the Services option. Be sure that the Create Account option is selected. Review the integration details in the summary screen. Now that both the invoke and trigger are in place, map the data to be shared between them. The source data structure is on the left of the mapper, and the target data structure is on the right. To map the two fields, drag the name field from the source to the organization name field in the target. The green check mark and the line connecting them indicates that these fields are mapped. When the data structure is large, use the search feature to locate the next fields. To map, drag the number of employees field over the employees total field. Finally, search for the currency field and map currency name to currency code. Save and exit the mapper. Next, configure a business identifier. This identifier is used in the dashboard monitor to track the associated payload field in messages. During runtime, one identifier is required as the primary business identifier, but you can define as many as three. Now that the request is mapped, the mapper icon is green, and the progress meter is at 100%. Save and exit the canvas. Activate the integration by clicking the Activate button. The status is now active, and the integration is complete.